The animal kingdom is full of stories of animals going to impressive lengths to protect their young. While a bit strange, mouthbrooding is not different. Mouthbrooding refers to the parenting strategy in which the adult keeps their eggs or young offspring in their mouth. Also called oral or buccal incubation, this approach to parenting may have you raising an eyebrow. But let's let go of our attachments to mammalian wombs and child-safe cribs and consider that the mouth could offer a safe, cozy spot for some species. Mouthbrooding is a fascinating life history strategy, but it makes a lot of sense. Many fish and amphibians lay hundreds of eggs in very vulnerable places. Mouthbrooders reduce that risk dramatically. By housing their eggs and fries in their mouths, very few are predated. Among these different species, there are a couple of different types of mouthbrooding behaviors. Depending on the species, sometimes the mouthbrooder is the female, maternal mouthbrooding, and sometimes the male, paternal mouthbrooding. For maternal mouthbrooding fish, the female will lay the eggs, scoop them up in her mouth, then the male will fertilize them. On the other hand, in species with paternal mouthbrooding, spawning happens before the male houses the fertilized eggs. Interestingly, these differences have brought to light some fascinating trends about sexual selection. For mouthbrooding animals, the mate that extends parental care is the subject of intense competition by the other mate. For example, in cichlid fish, the females are usually the mouthbrooders. Therefore, the males intensely compete with one another for mates. For the African cichlid, the male will first dig out a nest in the substrate, then perform a dance to attract the female into the den. It's the reverse for cardinal fish, in which the males are the mouthbrooders. In that case, the females compete with one another for their mates. The reason for this competition has to do with time and energy. In both paternal and maternal mouthbrooding fish, the parent that doesn't mouthbrood has a higher reproductive rate than a clutch of eggs can hatch. While there are a few mouthbrooding frogs, the behavior is actually more typical in fish. In fact, this strange form of parental care is found in 9 different families of fish. Cichlids, cardinal fish, sea catfish, bagrid catfish, snakeheads, snailfish, jawfish, gouramas, and arowanas. However, providing such safe, cozy spot for their youngs comes at a cost. When your mouth is full of eggs or fries, the more typical mouth functions become more difficult. With limited space in the buccal cavity, mouth-brooding fish typically don't eat while they have eggs in their mouths. Depending on the species, it can be 1 to 2 weeks before the eggs hatch. So these parents face quite the evolutionary trade-off, sacrificing significant amounts of energy to give the young a safe place to hatch. While the primary goal of mouth-brooding is to protect the young, there's a chance that a few might be swallowed. In the case of unfertilized eggs, the mouth-brooding female might intentionally swallow them. But some species of cardinal fish have been documented to even eat some of the fertilized offspring. It's unclear whether this act of cannibalism is completely accidental or they're just desperate for a snack. Another very brutal risk to mouth-brooders is brood parasites. A common phenomenon in birds, a mother will lay her eggs in another bird's nest to avoid taxing parental care. This happens to mouth-brooding fish as well. For example, the machukid catfish will trick a neighboring mouth-brooding cichlid into including its eggs in its brood. From here, the cichlid would start taking care of the eggs as if her own. Unfortunately for the cichlids, the catfish eggs hatch first, and the young fries feed on the yolk of the remaining eggs. With only catfish fries remain, the cichlid mother continues to believe those are her fries. Ironically, the cichlid whose brood these catfish fries destroyed is the only parent they will ever know.